Ted Sorensen was born in Lincoln, Nebraska, and graduated from Lincoln High School and then the University of Nebraska-Lincoln with bachelor's and law degrees. He went on to serve as special counsel, advisor, and speechwriter for John F. Kennedy from 1953 until Kennedy's assassination in 1963.
How long did it take you to figure out how to write to how he spoke?
In 1956, almost by accident, JFK became a national political figure when he was for one brief, exciting period, a potential candidate for the vice presidential nomination. He then left for a vacation in Europe. His father was relieved that he had been not nominated for vice president because his father was convinced that the presidential nominee, Adlai Stevenson, was going to lose, and he thought if he loses in big in 1956, everybody will blame it on his having a Catholic as his running mate, because no Catholic had been nominated since Al Smith went down to a disastrous defeat in 1928 as the Democratic presidential nominee. So JFK came back from, I still couldn't see this in my mind's eye, came back from his vacation in Europe. I came over to his house and I dumped on his dining room table a stack of mail, all of which were invitations from all over the country. Come speak. Mostly from Democrats, but not all Democrats. A lot of civic organizations, schools, everybody wanted him to come and speak. And I had roughly organized it by area and by date so that we could try to make a schedule out of it. And at the end of that session, he said, you might as well come along with me. For the next 3 years, in a sense 4 years, we traveled the country together to all 50 states with him speaking every day, sometimes several times a day, and me sitting in the audience listening. Well, I'll tell you, there's nothing like getting out there on the stump and speaking every day to improve one's speaking skills. And there's nothing like listening to him day after day for a speechwriter to find out what goes and what doesn't, what works and what doesn't work, what kind of phrases to use, what kind of organization he handles best, and so on. So our style and our standard fused and grew together.
Through this period, are you not only supplying him with the words, are you also giving him, in effect, drama lessons, in effect, presentation lessons?
I didn't really give him much by way of drama or presentation lessons. This was the early age of television, and John F. Kennedy was a natural on television. He was totally relaxed and cool. He looked so good. He was handsome. He had a beautiful smile, and he smiled a lot because he felt at ease on television, whether he was speaking or being interviewed. I didn't need to give him lessons.